So if you heard the word Mucuna and your first instinct was to respond with bless you or Gesundheit, this probably isn't the right place for you. However, if you heard Mucuna and your interest has piqued because you're a person with Parkinson's disease who wants to explore using Mucuna pruriens to improve your symptoms, this is definitely the right place for you, friend. Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast. We're definitely talking about that topic today, Mucuna pruriens. If you're watching on YouTube, I wanted to invite you to please like the video, share it with other people that you know that might benefit from this knowledge and information. And also, please subscribe to the channel. Make sure to hit that notification bell so that you don't miss any future episodes. And it also will really help us here on the channel to share the information that we're providing with as many people as possible. Up to 80% often of those watching the videos here on YouTube are not subscribed. So why not? It doesn't cost you a dime. All this information comes to you directly for free. So it only helps more people, as I said, to get the information that they need about Parkinson's. So without further ado, we'll dive into the introduction. I'll see you on the other side where we're going to talk more about Mucuna pruriens. Go.
Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing. And for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show.
So what is Mucuna pruriens? Mucuna is actually a bean, or the velvet bean, part of the Fabaceae family of plants, or the bean family. And Mucuna, of interest to persons with Parkinson's disease, contains natural levels of levodopa. As a matter of fact, the levodopa that was developed originally in the 1960s was developed or extracted from the fava bean. Research shows that Mucuna might reduce Parkinson's symptoms and might actually have quicker effectiveness as well as longer duration with helping with symptoms, even compared to medications like carbidopa, levodopa. There are some problems with Mucuna pruriens, and I want to make sure I highlight those for you as to not give the impression that I'm truly recommending this. Just to simply inform you before you go out and look for Mucuna pruriens to try to take it on your own, you want to make an informed decision about that, and that's what I'm trying to do today. So something that's distinctly different about taking Mucuna, which even though it's natural, it's not the same as a medication. Carbidopa levodopa specifically contains carbidopa, which that medication, when combined with levodopa, is specifically designed to reduce some of the gastrointestinal symptoms that you might experience by taking levodopa by itself, namely nausea and vomiting and or stomach pain and cramps. The other problem with Mucuna is that there's no standardized dosing, and research really hasn't shown a true way to recommend that to this point. And therefore, it's really difficult to advise anybody on how much to take and when, because there's really no standardized way to recommend that or to prescribe it. That's a problem because with no real baseline to go off of, there's not really any way to recommend to any specific individual how much to try to take. What is known is that the amount of levodopa found in the beans is between 60 to 500 milligrams. But again, it's not regulated, so you don't know really how much you're absorbing and how much bioavailability there is of what you're consuming with the Mucuna. The research just is not there quite yet. This may not be a problem initially, but it could be an issue down the road, especially as you're progressing through Parkinson's disease 5 or 10 years later. There's a neurologist named Dr. Luis Zayas who practices in Tennessee in the United States of America. He had some pretty strong words to say about supplements like Mucuna pruriens. In fact, he specifically talked about it in one of his videos, and I wanted to show you that clip here.
This is my opinion regarding supplements, specifically Mucuna pruriens. If you live in USA, there is no need to use these products. There's no need, there's no reason to take these type of risk. However, if you are doing well taking this product, Mucuna, getting the best of you, then continue with that. Why to change something that's working for you? If you live in a country with limited resources, then it is an option if you have the correct guidance from a neurologist in your area. if you ask me whether I will take this product, Mucuna, pruriens, if I have Parkinson's disease, the answer is no. I will be taking Ritari or regular Sinemet in combination with a very well-designed exercise program and a balanced diet.
I want you to pay close attention to what you said at the end there. Combining medication like Sinemet or Ritari with a specifically designed exercise program and a balanced diet. Now, he says balanced diet, but the interpretation of that would be an anti-inflammatory diet, because he gave the example of the MIND diet, which is one of the multiple anti-inflammatory diets that you might try as something that you could do as a dietary lifestyle change with Parkinson's disease. I happen to agree with Dr. Zayas that it's a combination of things. It's not one thing or the other. So in my opinion about Mucuna pruriens, and I'm not a physician, so take my opinion with a grain of salt, but as a healthcare clinician, I can tell you that my recommendation would be take the medications as prescribed by your physician who's treating you for the condition of Parkinson's disease. Find somebody like myself or another person who specializes in Parkinson's, that's especially a therapist, who can prescribe a very specific, well-designed exercise program for you, and then also to explore anti-inflammatory diets. I'm going to put a link in the upper right-hand part of the screen on a video that I did on the ketogenic diets and how that could potentially help you, even though that's not the only approach you could or should use. All of that being said, if you notice an improvement in symptoms while taking Mucuna pruriens, I would recommend to continue doing so. And Dr. Zayas actually said the same thing in his video. I'll put a link to his full video in the description of this video below. I'll also put a link to potential resources in terms of where to find Mucuna pruriens, especially where to find Mucuna pruriens that's pure and well manufactured, to the best of my ability to vet that. I don't make any promises there because I don't take it myself and I haven't vetted it myself, but I wanted to at least give you the opportunity to explore that and provide you with those links below. So to summarize this video, Mucuna pruriens is probably not a good long-term solution for you with Parkinson's disease. It's probably not something that you can truly know how much it's helping you or how much it isn't, except by basing it on symptoms. But as far as dosing, there's really no way to know exactly how much to take or how much you're really getting. But you could take it and proceed with caution. I would not recommend it as a replacement for your Parkinson's medications, but as a supplement to them, as with all the other supplements that we've talked about on this podcast. I don't ever recommend it being the only thing that you do. But if it works for you as an adjunct to the treatment you're getting for Parkinson's, it's a really good thing to continue doing. Because if it's helping you, even if it's just the perception of it improving your symptoms, in the long run, that's going to do a lot for you in terms of positive thinking, in terms of your mindset and your wellness, well-being as a person with Parkinson's. So do as much as you can to help yourself. That's going to wrap up today's episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Please leave your comments below letting me know what your experience has been taking Mucuna pruriens or any other supplements we've discussed. Any other supplements that I haven't discussed, because there's probably more that I have not brought up on the show at this point. And I'd love to explore those further if you think it's worth my looking into. I can share it with you here on the podcast. Thanks again for watching. Once again, don't forget to show some support for the companies that support this channel. And you can find those links in the description below. With Comfort Lending, you get a 15% discount off your entire purchase if you choose to use that link. So thanks again. I'll see you in the next episode. As always, be empowered.